And that is why the Indians deserved it. All right, we have some special visitors with us today, and I know you're gonna all give them your undivided attention. Please welcome the Be Safe Gang.
Woo!
What's up? What's up, you guys? I'm Fred from the Minneapolis Police.
I'm Karen from the Minneapolis Police.
And I'm Davida, formerly of the Minneapolis Police. And we want you
to be
safe
in
and around
the places
you work
and
live.
Hey, dudes. I'm here today to talk to you about the danger of drugs, okay? Who here likes to take drugs? Nobody. Nice try. I am very aware of what you kids are into, okay? I know the stories. I've heard about ravers who've OD'd on monkey vitamins. Sound familiar, Hotshot? Nice try. All right, show of hands. Who here is into teabagging? Go ahead, laugh, laugh. Dead people don't laugh, so enjoy it. As you know, teabagging is the act of dipping a household sponge into liquid ecstasy and then popping it into your rectum before a night of dancing.
Can I go to the nurse?
Nice try. All right, you kids need to be aware and prepared in case a stranger approaches you at a disco and says, "Hey, buddy, can you hold my sponge in your butt while I go get a drink?"
Who would do that?
How about 1 million people, rookie? Nice try. Protect yourself. 1 out of every 2 kids dies from being stupid. Take it, Karen.
Yeah. Yo, what's up, homies? Sex, humping, finger shrimping, toe blasting. Fun, right? Think again. Let's role play. Hey, you wanna touch my breasts?
Yeah, sure.
Boom! You just got genital diabetes. You don't know me. Jesus! Come on, people. Role play. Hey, you and me about to engage in intercourse. You gonna wear a condom?
Definitely.
Boom! You just got crotch botulism. AKA crotchulism. Condoms scoop up all the bacteria in the room and put it right in your penile canal. Do not wear them. And if you must wear one, you poke a hole in it to let the bacteria ventilate. Officer Fred.
Good job.
Yeah.
Good job. Way to go. What's up, guys? I'm here to talk to you about self-defense, keeping safe on the streets and in your school. Now, Davida and Karen over here are gonna be my attackers. Now, what do you do if someone attacks you? What do you do? You!
You, call the police? You run and get help?
Wow. I hope you get mugged today, my friend. Somebody attacks you, use your body. You don't need any weapons. Let me demonstrate. Someone's coming towards you, you can use your fingers to blind the assailant. You can configure the perpetrator's way in such a way to get away from you. Watch, for example, arm up, arm down, arm up, arm down, head down, shoulder down, head back up, mouth open, mouth closed, turn cheek, push, and she's on her way. You can clap your hands to deafen the assailant.
Ah! It's all about staying protected and aware. We did a little experiment with you guys.
We watched you guys take showers after gym class.
None of yous knew we were there.
Yeah, we knew you were there.
Yeah, nice try.
When is it not appropriate to fight back? When do you not fight back, you?
When someone has a gun.
someone is holding a gun?
Wow. I hope you get assaulted every day for the rest of your life. Someone has a gun, you fight back. Okay? This person's got about a quarter of an inch she can use to pull that trigger. I always carry a pen with me everywhere I go. Pull the gun towards you, put the pen right here. She can't pull the trigger. If you don't have a pen, grab one from the assailant. Okay, when all else fails, use your cell phone. You got a double attack. Pretend like you're having a conversation and they'll leave you alone. Watch.
Give me your money. I said, give me your money. Oh, sorry, sorry.
Hey, hey! Oh, my bad. Just remember, everybody, when you are in a dangerous situation, keep your mind in the sky.
Enjoy your surroundings.
Take your time.
And keep your arms constantly moving.
Be safe.
Be safe. Good job, you guys.
Good class. Good job. Good job.